谢谢大家来到这一场议程。那我们下一个议程是来自日本的讲者，他是来自日本的阿兹西西蒙诺桑。那他将为大家介绍的是 Standardization of Web Technology and its Solution for IoT Interoperability. 对不起。So let's give him a hand and welcome his talk.
Thank you for introduction. Let me move to my slide. So, let me introduce standardization of web technologies and its solution for IoT interoperability in 30 minutes. Half for standardization process and half for introduction of Web of Things specifications. So, slide is on screen now. Fine. Okay. So, my talk will be coordinated in four items. First, let me introduce briefly W3C process and how we organize our work on standardization. And also I will introduce WT concept and protocol as one example for extension of the web in briefly. So, we have this kind of a model to start for our work. So from top to bottom, top is gathering the requirements or ideas for standardization, and work goes through top to bottom, and we will release recommendations for build specs. So for the first moment, we usually organize workshops to gather inputs and requirements from broad peoples from public. And these workshops will be open to the public, and report and slide will be made public as for each workshop. And this is one example that we had one workshop on web and 5G network in 2018. And there is a workshop report having a summary and slide, and also what we decided to do after this workshop, like building task force for next step. And then following such kind of items to be found and decided during workshop, usually we put new requirement or ideas to existing working group, or we build task force to form further work, like building some working group or other format. So in this case, interest group was coordinated, and also it's now working to build a spec as a working group. So I put links in the bottom of the slide, but please check. I think slide will be published after the conference, so please check details following these links. So once we form some organized ideas or requirement, we form groups And there is several kind of groups before getting into working group to produce deliverables as specifications. One is a community group. This is a quite light group. Everyone can join without any patent description or any solid process. So in this group, open discussion will be held for gathering requirement into solid ideas, like we want to make this set of specifications. And in other places, interest group is a forum for exchanging ideas. So this is a casual discussion place for ideas and getting many input from various parties, like companies working for markets. And in other places, a business group is formed for coordinating requirement by use case basis. Many companies joined to this group to bring their requirement and use cases to be input to specific working groups. And then from these three kind of groups, a working group will be coordinate or existing working group will get a new requirement which can be built as a new specification or upgrade existing specifications. Once a working group was decided to work on solid area, draft specification will be made, and we will work following a formal process from draft to recommendation. So this is our process from working draft. So the leftmost side is a first public working draft, and working group works on draft to build a well-formed specifications, and WCC provides some review procedure or call for consensus within working group. And finally, we will release a recommendation after many reviews and agreement within working group. Review includes some special ones, like we formed a group to review on several points, like technology, security, privacy, internationalization, and accessibility. So these reviews are important to build specs to mature not requirement side, but the horizontal side
No worries. Take your time.
These reviews give specs to be formed in well right and level of each areas. So all of these processes are described in detail in our process document. And then you may know that FATWG for HTML or DOM having a living standard model, which is a continuous update on recommendation. And following to be capable to have such things in WCC, we also introduced candidate recommendation draft model for continuous updating models. So this is introduced quite recently, like last month, and we think some working group like CSS will adopt into this model for continuous updates. So that is the overview of W3C process. And then we are working for mainly for web technologies, and also working for technologies nearby web. So like a web GPU or machine learning, we are trying to include into the web. And also, in addition to web browsers, HTML plus CSS are used in smart TV or web as OS, Chrome OS. So we are not working only for the web browsers, but also this kind of adapting market areas. Like this is a distributed self identity called as DID, used for digital identifier. And also, this is today's one topic, Web of Things, building block for IoT devices. And also, for these, W3C itself is working for specifications, but also we are in collaboration to build these specs to make collaborated and mature specifications could be easily used in relationship. So there's several formal conversations between standard organizations like a review and joint call or joint working groups. So there is a bunch of liaisons with other organizations in W3C. Also, this kind of review on specs normally held for new recommendations within process of upgrade drafts. So from now, let me briefly introduce Web of Things, WOT technologies. WOT working group had published 2 recommendations and 3 notes this April. This is the adoption of web technologies and architecture into IoT areas. And this spec is seeking to counter the fragmentation of the IoT by standard data model and standard building blocks to make easy integration across various IoT platforms and protocols to build a smooth integration of the applications. So image shows an overview of WOT technologies, and I will give brief description in following slides. First of all, one of the WOT specification is named as WOT Thing Descriptions Format, usually called as TD. And this is a JSON format to describe each thing, like what this thing will provide as a status or what this thing accept a command. So from this description, user can know what kind of activity can be provided from each thing once connected to each device. I will show one example of this format later. And then, following TD, this TD data, consumer will access to a device by itself or via some services and interact to their status or their actions. For this WOT defines a binding template to bind the WOT JSON format into each specific data format, like MQTT has a binary format for communications to pass status data or commands. So using this binding template, consumer or proxy server can bind the WOT data model into each specific IoT protocols. So this is one example of things description taken from specification. I will show in details in following two slides. Sorry, this is quite long in a small font. So the first part, in the top of things description data format, one ID is provided to be recorded in directory. So this is the ID of each thing to identify things as one item. And title is a title of things. And then the middle part is the main part of defining what things will provide or what things can do. So there are just several namespaces to define activities of things. One is a property showing in this slide. Properties means status which can be acquired from things or pushed to things. You may notice there is a forms.op in this description there is a read property and write property. So this property can be read and write from consumer to thing. And also this just says as a string, but there is many other types like numerical values for something for temperature or the things. So you can define a property or a command parameters as this properties, and then this is another part, and actions define the actions which things can accept to work on. So for light switches, things need to accept command like on or off. So these kind of actions can be defined in this section. And the last is the event invoked from things to consumer. This is something like a callback from things to consumer. So with these three parts, WOT data format can describe things to be used from consumer. And with these, user can know, can tell what kind of actions can be commanded to things and what kind of data can be retrieved from these. So this is an overview of WOT technologies and also actually that is a first level of WOT release, but there is missing or additionally required features to make WOT technologies easy to use or to be capable for various areas like smart cities. So after publication of one's recommendation, we usually work on future passes. So this is a life cycle of building building future. So the bottom one is a standardization, like to publish a recommendation. But after that, implementations will happen and deployment will follow. From that, many new use cases or requirements will be flow out from real user. So we, using these use case and new requirement, we build a list of new requirements to be inputted to new specifications. And also for this kind of gathering inputs, we also use workshops or hack days to get great input. So let me introduce some upcoming ones in following two slides. And first is web and machine learning. So this is adoption of machine learning into the web, mainly web browsers or web APIs. We will publish slides and videos of this workshop shortly, and virtual sessions will be held in September. If you are interested in this area, please register to the workshop from URL at the bottom. And also, there is another workshop on maps for the web. This is a joint workshop among OGC and W3C, like map tiling of map into the web. From this, also in the WOT areas, these kind of activities are held, like Plugfest or Hack Days. And this is an example of Plugfest held in the conference last year, like a smart TV, a smart speaker, or intelligent light connected through WOT technologies. And also there is a joint workshop between W3C and IRTF held this year. Using this kind of workshop and real connection fest, we are building new requirement or use cases to be input to WOT. This is the last slide of my talk. Thank you for listening.
Thank you. And is there any question? Okay, there's one question. Wait a minute.
Hi, sir. Recently, I've been working on an IP camera that is used to be an it should be belongs to IoT or even WoT. And then because due to the development of the AI, right? There is some kind of object detections or even actions detections, something like that, should be combined to like the features of this kind of IP camera or each edge devices. And then there will be some kind of, you know, restrictions of the hardware. Like you cannot put such kind of GPUs into those edge devices. And then therefore I would like to ask some suggestions from you. Like would you like to recommend to put these services computational cost to cloud cloud computing, or even just put those computational cost on edge devices, and then edge devices will like after those computation and then give the results to upload to the cloud. Which kind of solution would you recommend the most, and what's their pros and cons?
I think that depends on network bandwidth mainly. So like camera or video stream may eat large bandwidth to stream all data into cloud. So like in smart city hackathon, there was a use case of local 5G to be adopted into these cameras to gather image stream into the central server or uploading to the cloud through central server. If there is no such good network connection, I think it's quite hard to stream this large volume of data through narrow network. So I just can say it should depends on other limitations. So from our organization, we are working on network quality, network quality measurement and data gathering in web and network working group following web 5G workshop. And also there is some discussion within WoT group through joint meeting with smart city people.
And thank you for your joining the Coast Cup from Japan. We're really glad that we can have your talk. And
thank you for invitation, and I really wanted to go to Taipei.
And we really hope next year we can meet you in person.
Yeah, I really hope so.
Okay, then everyone please give him a hand. Thank you. And bye-bye.